and welcome to a special edition of In Depth. I'm Smriti Rastogi. Results of the assembly elections for the four states that were held simultaneously with the Lok Sabha elections were no less dramatic than the massive victory that Prime Minister Narendra Modi-led BJP won in the country. The elections were held to Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim state assemblies. In Odisha, the BJD swept the polls with a thumping victory, with Naveen Patnaik all set to become the chief minister for the fifth time in a row. In Andhra Pradesh, the YSR Congress Party won an even more overwhelming majority in the assembly. In the process, it flattened the Chandrababu Naidu-led Telugu Desam party in the state. In Arunachal Pradesh, the BJP comfortably crossed the majority mark in the 60-seat assembly. Another setback was suffered by Chief Minister Pawan Chamling in the state of Sikkim. The opposition, Sikkim Krantikari Morcha, ended his 25-year rule in a close contest. Our edition of In Depth today analyzes the assembly election results in all these states and some profiles, some of the main actors who won and lost at the elections. One of India's most successful chief ministers, Naveen Patnaik, has led the Biju Janata Dal back to power in Odisha for a fifth consecutive term, defying anti-incumbency. Odisha, which is never known to vote on caste and religious lines, chose to repose its faith in Patnaik after having him at the helm for 20 years. Naveen Patnaik-led Biju Janata Dal clinched a clean sweep in Odisha assembly elections. However, this time, BJP increased the vote margin than the previous elections.
Odisha Chief Minister and BJD President Naveen Patnaik is a happy man after registering his fifth win in a row in the assembly polls handsomely. The ruling Biju Janata Dal in Odisha is forming the government after bagging 112 of the 146 assembly seats in the state. Patnaik contested the state election from two seats, Hinjali in Ganjam district and Bijapur in Bargarh for the first time. The chief minister has been representing Hinjali since 2000. The victory makes Patnaik one of the longest serving chief ministers in the country. Patnaik became chief minister of Odisha in 1997. He never lost in the five assembly elections.
I would like to express my deep gratitude to the people of our state for having showered their blessings on us time and time again. I would also like to thank the leaders and workers of the party who worked so hard for this election, and also all the women who came out in large numbers to vote for us.
Odisha, for example, Odisha is one of the states which came into existence, and there has been a dominance of Congress for a very long period of time in Odisha. In fact, Patnaiks have been ruling, whether it was Congress or it is now the BJD. So even after the ouster of Congress, the regional political party has been ruling there for a quite long time, and I think this is the fifth time that Biju Janata Dal has been returned to power. It means that it depends on the perception and credibility of the leader at the state level, whether it is a national leader or it is a national party or a regional party. People, in fact, go by the perception.
The Naveen Patnaik-led party won 112 seats in the 146 seats assembly. The BJP emerged as the main opposition in the state, winning 23 seats. The Congress, which was the main opposition to the BJD since 2000 elections, has been reduced to 9 seats. The BJD won 45% vote share in the state. The BJP, on the other hand, bagged almost 33% votes. The Congress got just 16% of the vote share.
I think the BJP had quite a bit of understanding. They looked upon the Lok Sabha, BJP I'm talking about, and the state they left it for the BJD to take care of. And I think the formula has worked very well, and BJP has also got quite a few seats in Lok Sabha from Odisha, as well as BJD has got. So both of them, they would become partners in development. I think it's a good sign for the state government to have a good equation with the center.
The Lok Sabha and Assembly elections in Odisha took place in four phases on April 11th, 18th, 23rd and 29th. The major national parties that contested the elections were the BJD, the Indian National Congress and the BJP. The BJD's campaign relied exclusively on the popularity of Patnaik's image. Patnaik, who launched a host of development schemes, including his pre-poll subsidy for farmers, has managed to rebut any challenges mounted by the BJP. In 2014 Odisha Assembly election, the BJD won 117 seats in the 147-strong assembly. The Congress won 16 seats, while the BJP took 10 of the 147 assembly seats. Before the gradual rise of Biju Janata Dal formed by the Biju Patnaik and his son Naveen Patnaik, the political arena was dominated by the Congress. The upsurge of the Congress as the only secular, progressive force in Odisha was countered by the BJD that managed to gain a majority for the last four terms in a row. The BJP also made a mark in the state and is now considered as an important party in Odisha. Apart from the BJD, the major parties in the state are Jharkhand Mukti Morcha, the All India Trinamool Congress, the Janata Dal United, the Lok Jan Shakti Party, Revolutionary Socialist Party and Samajwadi Party. Odisha, earlier known as Orissa, has a rich and varied political tradition. However, its political prominence was heightened after it was granted complete statehood in 1950. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
The YSR Congress Party secured a landslide victory in both the Assembly and Lok Sabha elections in Andhra Pradesh. In the process, it decimated Chief Minister N. Chandrababu Naidu's Telugu Desam Party in Andhra Pradesh. The YSR CP secured 150 seats out of 175 Assembly seats and 23 out of 25 Lok Sabha seats.
Sweet victory for a man fighting to secure a political prize that he has been claiming for over 10 years. When votes were counted for Andhra Pradesh state elections on Thursday, Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy's party, YSR Congress, had virtually decimated the Chandrababu Naidu-led TDP in the state. The YSR CP won 151 seats in 175-member assembly in the state. The ruling Telugu Desam Party won 23 seats, while the Janasena Party accounted for the remaining seat. The victory meant that the YSR CP may end up with over a 3/4 majority in the 175-member assembly. With more than 2/3 of the state assembly seats under his belt, the YSR CP chief, Reddy, on Thursday described it as a people's victory.
They dominated the people and they exploited them for their own political ends. And ultimately, because the regional leaders emerged, and they Telangana for Telangana's, Telanganites, Andhra for Andhraites, that kind of feeling emerged, which may not be very good in the long run. But as it has emerged, Congress has not been able to come back after N.T. Rama Rao in Andhra Pradesh. And even after N.T. Rama Rao's death, TDP has not been allowing the Congress to come back. Though now, even in the Congress, there was a split when the YSR Congress Party, Jagan Mohan Reddy, came back and split the Congress. And now the competition is between YSR Congress and TDP. not between the national political party Congress and the regional political parties.
Even as trends indicated a clear lead for the YSRC, TDP President Chandrababu Naidu forwarded his resignation from the Chief Minister's post to the State Governor E.S.L. Narasimhan, who accepted it. The 2019 state elections were the first assembly polls of the residual Andhra Pradesh 5 years after its bifurcation on April 11, 2014. In 2014, the TDP had bagged 102 assembly seats. At the time, the TDP contested the election in alliance with the BJP. It fought the 2019 general elections on its own and faced a rout. The state elections were fought on the demand for a special category status for Andhra Pradesh, which the winning YSRC chief asserted would continue.
Andhra Pradesh also, because the BJP in South India had base only in Karnataka, where they have done well again, you know, in the Lok Sabha elections. But in Andhra Pradesh, Chandrababu Naidu's, the way this government was functioning, the another force which emerged of YSR Reddy, Jagan Reddy's party, has done remarkably well in the state. They have swept the entire state, and now they are going to form the government. And Jagan Reddy had, before the election results, had said they would support anybody at the center who would give them special status.
The victory turned the spotlight on Jagan Reddy, the son of former Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Y.S. Rajasekhara Reddy, who wanted to contest the Lok Sabha elections in 2004. The Congress, however, didn't allow it. Jagan's formal political debut came in 2009, when he won the Kadapa Lok Sabha seat as the Congress nominee. He made his ambitions to become the Chief Minister known after his father's tragic death in a helicopter crash in September 2009. But the Congress did not agree, forcing Jagan to leave the party. During the campaigning, the TDP focused on its promise of planning a world-class capital of Amaravati for the state and the Polavaram project. In the run-up to the election, it was also blamed for engineering the defection of the 23 YSRCP MLAs, four of whom were made ministers. TDP chief N. Chandrababu Naidu claimed his government had schemes that addressed the needs of all the sections. Jagan's campaign included a 3,648 kilometers long padayatra across Andhra Pradesh. He also popularized 9 promises in a document to meet people's expectations. The assembly election marks a defining moment for Andhra Pradesh. The victory of Jagan Mohan Reddy put a question mark on TDP President Chandrababu Naidu's attempt to mark his stamp in national politics with the formation of the Third Front. With inputs from Leena Sharma, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
On that note, we'll slip into a very quick break. Stay with us.
Watch The Big Picture with me, Frank Rausen Pereira, at 6:30 p.m.
The prolific British poet and story writer Joseph Rudyard Kipling, one of the first masters of short stories in English. In 1894 appeared his Jungle Book, which became a children's classic all over the world. Kim, the story of Kimball O'Hara and his adventures in the Himalayas, is perhaps his most felicitous work published. Set in and concerned with India he had come to know and love so well. In 1907, Kipling became the first English language writer to receive the Nobel Prize for Literature.
Tales that inspire. Stories of social change. A salute to diversity. promoting public discourse. Events that motivate, inspiring the innovative spirit. Watch Rajya Sabha television documentaries.
Welcome back after the break. BJP for the first time will be forming government in the Himalayan state, Arunachal Pradesh. After the results, Chief Minister Pema Khandu called it a victory of the people and their faith in the leadership of Modi. Here is a detailed report.
The ruling BJP comfortably crossed the 31-seat mark in Arunachal Pradesh to claim a majority in the 60-seat assembly. The JDU, which made its maiden entry into the electoral scene of Arunachal Pradesh, won 7 seats, while debutant National People's Party or NPP secured 4 seats. The Congress managed to hold its ground only on 4 seats. The lone regional outfit, People's Party of Arunachal, PPA, backed a single seat, while 2 independents clinched 1 seat each. The BJP won over 51% votes, while the Congress backed over 17% votes. The JDU polled over 10% votes in the assembly elections. The BJP will for the first time form government in the Himalayan state with the support of its own MLAs. Arunachal Pradesh Chief Minister Pema Khandu won from Mukto Assembly constituency for the third time in a row, defeating his lone rival Thupten Kunfen of the Congress by a margin of 2,602 votes. Khandu won the seat in 2011 by election and was re-elected unopposed in 2014. His political journey began after his father and former chief minister Dorji Khandu died in a helicopter crash near Luguthang in Tawang district in April 2011. In the 2014 assembly elections, the Congress won 42 seats, the BJP 11, the PPA 5 and 2 independents won 1 seat each. With inputs from Lina Sharma, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Pawan Kumar Chamling's Sikkim Democratic Front rules Sikkim virtually uncontested for nearly 25 years in power. In 2014, SDF bagged 22 of the state's 32 total seats in the Legislative Assembly. But this time, the tables turned. The opposition Sikkim Krantikari Morcha won 17 assembly seats, while the ruling Sikkim Democratic Front managed only 15.
It was a close contest that ended with the opposition Sikkim Krantikari Morcha bringing to a close Chief Minister Pawan Kumar Chamling's 25-year rule in Sikkim. At the final count, the SKM had won 17 seats in the 32-seat assembly, while Chamling's party, Sikkim Democratic Front, got 15. Under the SDF, Sikkim has done economically well by becoming a state that earned the country's third highest per capita income after Goa and Delhi. The SDF pioneered in organic farming in innovative ways. During the campaigning, the opposition, led by the Sikkim Krantikari Morcha, however, focused on its failures on many fronts. They included seat reservation for the Nepali-speaking Limbu and Tamang communities of the state, besides the charges ranging from corruption to nepotism. Facing anti-incumbency, the SDF fielded many new faces for a fresh look.
See, Sikkim had been facing incumbency factor because Pawan Chamling's party, SDF, Sikkim Democratic Front, has been ruling the state for the last 25 years, 5 consecutive terms. And this is the 6th term he was seeking re-election. Because with the emergence of Sikkim Krantikari Morcha as a challenger, as a regional party which has challenged Sikkim Democratic Front, has emerged as a winner. People have accepted Sikkim Krantikari Morcha to replace SDF. Although they got very marginal win, Sikkim has total 32 seats and Sikkim Krantikari Morcha has managed to bag 17 out of it, and 15 seats have gone to SDF. I think it will be a good sign. Let the ruling party, which ruled for 25 years, now be in opposition and do the welfare of the people of the state.
In terms of vote share too, it proved to be a close contest. The SDF got a slightly higher vote share of 47.6% but lost the assembly elections. The SKM, on the other hand, got 47% votes in the state. Chamling won the Pokhlok Kamrang assembly seat, defeating his nearest Sikkim Krantikari Morcha rival, Kharka Bahadur Rai. While SKM chief P.S.Goyla's son Aditya was declared a winner from Soring Chakung. The Baichung Bhutia-led Hamro Sikkim party failed to make an impact in the polls, along with Congress as well as the other smaller parties that were formed in a run-up to the polls.
Sikkim has always been in the hands of the regional party, almost without any kind of exception, right since its association. The reason is that the state, the people there, they think that regional leaders, their own leaders, can look after them better. They can understand their problems better than the national political parties.
The main opposition party, SKM, is part of the BJP's Northeast Development Alliance, with the ruling Sikkim Democratic Front and footballer turned politician Baichung Bhutia's Hamro Sikkim party did not form an alliance with any national party. In the 2014 assembly polls, the SKM challenged the SDF and cornered 10 seats. This time too, it raised its tally to 17, banking on the anti-incumbency of 25-year-old state government. With inputs from Leena Sharma, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And with that, it's a wrap on this edition of In Depth. We will be back same time on Monday with a focus on some other subject. You can also watch our program online on YouTube and Twitter. And don't forget to send back your valuable feedback and suggestions about our program. Thank you for watching.